Hey folks, welcome to the Jetcast channel, and rolled the camera a little bit late for this introduction today. It's one of those sort of fishing expeditions where it's hit and miss and it may not end up being a video, but luckily today I've had some success, very early success. Not only is it a big fish, but it's actually one I've never caught before, so stick around and you'll see the action. First, I might have lost that one. This one was flying, so I thought this might have been the mackerel. Oh, it's hard to wind when you got tooth. Oh, he's gonna go again. Lost this one. He's been bitten off. Alright, let's concentrate on one. The line back. I'm stressed. Should have my gaff ready, shouldn't I? Fish, so I don't want to force him. I get my gaff is what I want to get. Whoa. My reel is hot. He just peeled off about another 60 meters then. is this thing? Oh, the way it ran, it's got to be a mackerel or a wahoo. The fact that it's had a third run, I'm wondering, wahoo? Yeah, I got bitten off on that one. It's a decent fish. It's not my biggest rod, but it's a decent fish. You probably saw that panic look on my face. I was like, what the hell? I can see my leader, I just can't bring him up. He's just below the leader level. I'm tired. I think he'd have to almost had enough now. It's a good fish. It's a big Spanish, I think. Oh, it's a wahoo, I think. Ooh, a big wahoo. It's got the bars, but it's a wahoo. Whoops. Didn't want to do that. Come on, come on, come on, come on, come on. Whoa! I think I got him. Holy shit. Holy shit, this is a big one. Jesus! Oh man, that's the first wahoo I've ever caught, and it's got to be 1.4, 1.5 meters long. Man, and he weighs a ton. Absolute weighs a ton. No wonder I lost my other line, it just bit it off. Oh, I had a double hookup. I'm still shaking from adrenaline, I think. When I saw it. Oh man. Let me try to figure out how long this thing is. Okay. So he's looking about 1.6 meters long, it's looking. That's a beauty. Oh man, I don't know if I should keep fishing after that. Alright guys, that's what did the damage. I'm a shallow diver, but it's lost its bib after that effort. I'm not surprised. Whoa. My first Wahoo. And it's freaking huge. Now, one of the guys from the jet ski fishing groups that I'm in said he felt like somebody's going to catch a Wahoo today. And I said, nah, yeah, give it a go. My God, I can't believe it. I'll take a photo and send it to him. Very slippery. So unfortunately, I think I better cut this trip a little bit short. I've got this fish, my fish bag is split open, the ice has gone everywhere, it's gonna go off if I don't go home now. So, I mean, I can't complain, it's just gonna be a very short day. It's only like 7:30 in the morning. And I left it to the ramp about 5, I think. So, unfortunately, I think I better go back. I don't wanna spoil this fish. It's a good fish and deserves to be shared around and not spoilt. So I'm going to go home because A, my ice is going to melt, B, it's dragging on this side with the live bait tank anyway, so it's got to be like a, as I said, a 25, 30 kilogram fish. So it's putting a lot of weight plus the ice, what's left of it, onto this tubby. It's sort of, I thought I was sinking there for a minute when I was trying to troll. I was sort of going at 30, 40 degrees on the water, and then I realized it was just the pure weight the water was getting in through the open hatch. And I checked under the bonnet here, under the seat, so there's no water in the hull, thank goodness. Never is actually, but I thought I'd better check. So I'm gonna pack up now and get back early. Can't hurt, get the ski cleaned early, have a bit of a relax this afternoon, and live to fish another day. Anyway, thanks for joining me on the channel, and I'll see you next time.
down tonight.